Welcome back to the show. Back to tell you about the latest production of Orpheus Musical Theatre. It is called Dreamgirls. Here to tell us more about it, I am joined by the general manager himself, JT Morris, and their choreographer, Deborah Quaicoe. Welcome to you both. Great to have you back here.
Thank you.
Longest running musical theatre company in North America, right?
Canada, but
I, mean, I thought it was even North America. America. Am I making stuff up?
That. No,
right
I think
away?
We used to say that, and then we realized we were wrong.
Oh, really?
Yeah. There's one in the U.S.
Okay.
But we just celebrated our 118th birthday in January.
Just amazing. So, and I just had Ottawa Little Theatre on. They celebrated 111 years.
Yes.
We've got 118 years with Orpheus Musical Theatre. It's incredible.
And Ottawa Little Theatre is actually the longest running community theatre in Canada,
that's right.
We're musical theatre, it's all in Ottawa.
Let's talk about Orpheus and what makes it so unique and so special.
You know, the amazing thing about Orpheus is people like Deb and people like Rogers TV. It's all volunteer, and it's kind of crazy to imagine how 118 years in has been entirely volunteers until I came around. Before that,
and are you paying him? What is happening? Okay, just
what's amazing too is just the scale of the shows is what brings in people who either do it as a hobby or a ton of professionals who are retired or just in between gigs just because the quality is so high. So it's really something special.
Deborah, how'd you get involved?
I got involved in 2018. My first show was Mamma Mia, and I was a aerobics instructor actually at Good Life Fitness.
Okay.
And one of my members was into Orpheus Musical Theatre, was the director, and said, come on out. And I said, absolutely. Mamma Mia music, who doesn't want to dance
to it? No kidding.
And yeah, I had a great time and just was looking for ways to get back.
So you were a cast member at that point?
No, I was also a choreographer.
Okay, you were a choreographer for that as well. Let's talk about this latest production, Dreamgirls. Tell us a little bit about the storyline for those that aren't familiar.
So it's about the rise and fall of a trio of singers that are loosely based on the Shirelles and a lot of the Motown acts of the 60s and 70s. A whole bunch of love stories that come in and out, and I was going to say trauma. That's
trauma within the group
of the risk of somebody losing their spot in the group and somebody else taking over. So it's that classic pop star Justin Timberlake abandons NSYNC story in the 60s and 70s all set to Motown music.
Yeah. I love it. And that's the key here too. And maybe Deborah, you can talk about this. Tell me a little bit about the music itself. How would you describe the music in Dreamgirls?
I would say the music is very much based on that Motown era, so you know the Detroit music scene in the 50s, 60s, and 70s, and that rise from really that that Motown space right up into like a disco era is reflected in all the music, which is a lot of fun.
Oh. I mean, I know everybody looks at their own eras and says they're the best, but you know, just describing that, like that era of music, it is just so incredible, right? You're gonna teach us some dance moves today, is my understanding, right?
Are you a little choreo. Are you ready to be Dreamgirls?
So we have some, you guys sent some music along here. I'm going to ask Stephanie and Dave there in the control room to play some music, and as the music comes in, you can show us some moves here.
Absolutely. As soon as we get that music.
Maestro, do we have music? We tested this before. I hear it here.
Every man has his own special
dream. Like
this?
Hands on his head. Yes.
Okay.
Very much Dreamgirls energy.
Nice.
Oh, I
feel like a dream girl, Deborah.
That's incredible.
Way better than me.
I don't know. I wouldn't say that. Let's talk about the cast and crew, because, you know, I know that the cast, you know, oftentimes, you know, we're in front of the camera or on stage, but the crew are volunteers as well, right?
Absolutely, and for every show, it's over 100 crew members.
Really?
To put on every Orpheus show, entirely volunteers. And we get a lot of help from the Meridian Theatres at Centrepointe, where we perform with their volunteer base as well. But yeah, it's a solid 3 months that the crew members are putting into
Amazing.
This.
Amazing. Yeah. What about set design? Is that also volunteers? Or what is this? Tell me a little bit about this set, first of all.
This set actually is really exciting. Like you know, we've been trying to do firsts since coming back to the theater and everything. And this time, we have the first time Orpheus is ever doing a mechanical, massive, revolving stage.
Really?
So it's really taking over the Centrepointe stage.
Face. She's like, yes!
It is even better than you can imagine.
Really, eh?
Yes.
Just amazing. Yeah, I mean, that just amazing. And then your next performance is another classic. You're doing The Wizard of Oz, right?
Wizard of Oz, and auditions are coming up if anybody's interested. They are March 19th to the 22nd.
Okay.
But anybody can come down to Orpheus, 17 Fairmont Avenue on Monday, March 18th, 7 p.m. We'll have a meeting, a little social gathering about what you can expect with auditions.
Yeah,
the show.
What are you looking for?
We're looking
for obviously talent. I know that, but I mean, you're looking at triple
I've
threats,
been in a
right?
Show.
No, and I haven't. So that tells you something, yeah.
But definitely, singers, actors, dancers, but anybody can walk in. No experience is required. And the great thing about the show, like Wizard of Oz, just like Mary Poppins, the whole family can take part.
Yeah.
So kids can be in the show, help out in sets, costumes. Mom and dad can be anywhere because they probably won't be in the show. Let's be real. Everybody's welcome.
Awesome. I can't thank you both enough. I mean, the production, I went to see Mary Poppins and it just blew me away. Everyone that I spoke to that has gone to see any Orpheus musical theater production walks out of there going, I can't believe those are volunteers.
Yeah.
I mean, that's how great you guys do, you know, a great of a job you guys do. So congratulations to all of you. I know you put in a lot of work.
Thank
a lot,
you.
A lot of work.
Appreciate it.
I will thank you both. I remind you all at home, Dreamgirls coming up at Meridian Theatres at Centrepointe. That is March 1st to the 10th. Tickets are easy. You go to orpheusmusicaltheatre.com. Just click on Dreamgirls there. You can also subscribe and become a member and get some great discounts on tickets for a season as well. We'll be back right after this.